Ah, Fishing Simulator. A game about exploration. Hunting for treasure. Fishing. Filling out your aquarium. And hunting these magnificent creatures to extinction. Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new Fishing Simulator video. In the most recent update, they added 3 brand new spears. The Oathbreaker, Archangel and the Moby Spear. 2 of these spears, namely the Oathbreaker and the Archangel, are only obtainable in August. And the Moby Spear is a new gem spear. In this video, I want to go over all 3 of them and see if it's worth it to buy any of them in this short period of time. Without further ado, let's jump straight into it. Like you would have expected, these spears can be bought from Finn's Supply Shop, located at Port Jackson. Starting off with the Oathbreaker. Knights run in fear of this spear, abandoning their oaths. You can buy this spear for 5 million gold, and it does 450 damage. As for the effect when throwing a spear, the Oathbreaker looks kinda weird. It looks like it is glitching. Is this what they intended? Or did they mess something up with the code? Because it looks really weird to me. Like, really, really weird. That said, the effects when just holding it in your hand look super cool. The second spear is the Archangel. Cow down, the wrath of the Archangel. This one can be bought for 7 million coins. And even though the cost isn't that much increased compared to the Oathbreaker, the damage did actually got quite a lot of a boost, going to 525 damage. As for the visuals with Angelic, I absolutely love the particles around it. However, there is a little problem. When you throw it, the exact same thing happens as with the Oathbreaker. That the particles stay, but the spear is thrown. I don't know, it just looks really weird to me. Like, if this was intended, I really would like to know why they decided to do this. As it looks more of like a glitch than actual effect. That said, this spear is the coolest looking spear in the entire game. It is a kind of bad that it doesn't have a specialty, but still, like the way it looks amazing. Important to note that the Oathbreaker and the Archangel can only be bought in August 2020. And the last spear is the Moby Spear. Hypnotizing and menacing at the same time. This spear can be bought for 12,000 gems. To put that into perspective, that is roughly 3,000 Robux. It does 400 damage, making it the lowest damage spear that got added this update, but it has a specialty, 25% damage on Moby Wood, making the total damage against Moby Wood 500. Is this a joke? Why is this thing so expensive? Like, actually, like, this is not even funny anymore. 3000 Robux, 12,000 gems for a spear that is worse than a spear that you can buy with gold? Because for your information, the most expensive spear right now for gold is the Black Knight Spear, and it does 650 damage, which is already more than the Moby Spear. And on top of that, it is 20% more damage against all bosses, so Moby Woods and all bosses into the future, with a total damage of 780. How is a gold spear better than such an expensive gem spear? I have no idea. Don't buy the Moby spear. It is a waste of money and a waste of time. Skip it. Skip the Moby spear. It is not worth it. Go grind for the Oathbreaker. Go grind for the Archangel. Because those are limited. And then go buy the Black Knight's one. Because, let's be honest, the Moby spear is an absolute ripoff. A noob trap. Don't buy the Moby spear. Speaking of a ripoff and underwhelming, how can a spear this expensive with gems or Robux look so plain and boring? It has no effects, it looks boring, it just looks like a very early game spear. Why? I really don't get the Moby spear, I'm sorry. I have some pretty interesting facts about this update from one of the developers. Namely, all the new spears that got added this update are fan-made. And that is the reason why you can only buy them now in August. Because it's like, you want to collect them. Like, it's the rare thing that even if you don't use it, you can say, yeah, I got that. I was there. And that's something that I really, really like. It also kind of shows why these spears look so good. Because in most games, when fans design something, they don't have an entire book of, oh, this is what all the new stuff needs to be. It needs to be in this time period and stuff. Which is always why I find fan design so interesting. And it just always shows when games add stuff that's fan-made, it most of the time looks better, which is really cool and fun. Also, these spears will be the only spears with special particles. So only fan-made spears will have special particles. Although they do glitch a little bit. I'm still not sure if it was intended. It's still cool that those two spears and spears in the future that will be added that are fan-made will get those special effects to really separate them. And that's what I really, really like. This is what I have to say about the new spears. Get the Oathbreaker and the Archangel, as they are only available in August. Grind, grind, grind. Because it's gonna be kind of a shame if there are items in the game that you never can get anymore. But I would not recommend buying the Moby Spear. It is utterly useless and trash. How do I feel about this small spare update though? I feel like it was rushed. And hear me out why I say this. Not only do the particles stay when you throw the spear, like that can be a design point, but even when you look at my inventory right now, you will see that the model of the Archangel isn't even rotated properly in the menu. And if they tested this update, they would have seen that and fixed it. This update feels really rushed just to get some spears out so people got something to grind. So just grind the spears and just after that play the game how you normally would. That's what I recommend. I'm a little bit disappointed in the quality of the spears, even though the models look absolutely amazing. Like, no complaints about the models, except maybe the Moby spear, but like the Archangel spear looks amazing. That's my opinion on the update. Before I go, I just want to mention, because I haven't mentioned it yet, that I am on this content partner board. I mean, if you play Fishing Simulator, you probably already know this, because I've been there like for a month now. So basically, if I get subscribers, new codes get unlocked, which you can use to get gems. The reason why I'm saying this is that once the goal is reached, you only got like 3 or 4 days to claim the code. So the window of claiming the code is very, very small. So if you enjoy playing Fishing Simulator a lot, be sure to check this board out and use the codes very fast. Because it's gonna be pretty annoying if you miss them. But with that said, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye bye!